the Rosemont Horizon on the edge of downtown Chicago, Illinois, for the second round matchup. Much anticipated, highly attractive, the California Golden Bears against the Duke Blue Devils. The winner of this game will take on Kansas next week in St. Louis. It's the third-seeded Sookies against the California team, seeded number six. Good evening, everybody. I'm Vern Lundquist along with Clark Kellogg. A lot to look forward to in this game, not the least of which is the confrontation between Bobby Hurley and Jason Kidd.
Jason Kidd, the outstanding freshman guard from California, all Pac-10 as a freshman, a very physically strong point guard who does his work inside. Bobby Hurley, we know all about him, the all-time assist leader in NCAA history, and has oogobs of experience by virtue of going to three straight Final Fours.
Neither of these teams is a one-man team. For the Duke Blue Devils, they have Grant Hill back and apparently healthy now. And California has Lamond Murray. You really like him.
Well, both of these guys are stat sheet stuffer supreme. Anything that needs to be done on the basketball court, both of these guys do it. They score, rebound, steal, defend. They do everything.
Duke and California, we have a third member of our broadcasting trio here. Let's go to Leslie Visser right now.
Vern, a little more on one of the most anticipated matchups of the tournament, Hurley and Kidd. While they will not guard each other initially, Todd Bozeman told me he'll have K.J. Roberts on Hurley in the beginning. They will eventually meet and spark should fly. Jason Kidd told me just a couple of minutes ago he has a stomach full of butterflies, and to this minute, he and Bobby Hurley have never met. But Kidd said, I will measure my progress and the progress of the Cal program by how we play. Vern?
All right, Leslie, on the left, the lineups for California. Murray, Grigsby, Brian Hendricks, Roberts, who will get the Hurley assignment early, and Jason Kidd, the hero of the win over LSU when his scoop shot went in with a second to go. And for the Duke Blue Devils, Grant Hill, Antonio Lang, Cherokee Parks, Thomas Hill, and Bobby Hurley. Somewhere in the midst of that crowd, Mike Krzyzewski in his 13th season as the head coach of Duke, but playing just 9 miles from where he grew up. Family is here. And the head coach named the full head coach just 2 days ago in the middle of that crowd at 29 years of age, Todd Bozeman. It's a sellout. California has won 10 of its last 11. Duke has won the last two NCAA championship games. The officiating crew, John Corbin, Ted Hillary, and Eric Harmon. Duke is dressed in white. There is Mike Krzyzewski. California in the dark blue.
Really important to see what kind of poise California starts this game with. I think that will be critical, their attitude and their poise. Will they play relaxed and unafraid, or will they be on their heels? For Duke, the key for them is they've got to set the tone as they did the other night, take care of their business, and then they must put Cal into a half-court game. They can't allow California to get transition baskets.
Thomas Hill, guarded by Jason Kidd. And it is K.J. Roberts on Bobby Hurley, top of the key. That pass intended for Cherokee Parks. Off Parks, first turnover of the game, will go California's way.
Expect Thomas Hill to defend Jason Kidd if, in fact, they go man-to-man, because Jason Kidd is so strong physically. And there you see Thomas Hill, one of the best defenders in the country, matched up with Jason Kidd.
Jason Kidd kicked it back along the baseline to Grigsby. No good. Rebound, Lamond Murray. Foul call.
Here you take a look at Kidd, not able to shake free. Good help by Lang. Finds Grigsby for a good look. And watch Lamond Murray go upstairs, hopping to it. And I tell you what, folks, if you've not seen Lamond Murray, he is an absolute treat.
K.J. Roberts, alley-oop.
Yes, he is. He is as good as a yogurt sundae with all the fixings.
Steal by Kidd. K.J. Roberts. Yeah. Not nervous so far.
And that's so important that they get off to a strong start. And this young bunch from California. Take a look at Kidd finding Lamond Murray. Rise, young fella, rise.
That is so reminiscent of a basket made by Grant Hill early in his career at Duke. And there is Grant Hill playing with a badly sprained left toe, but he had a reverse dunk in their win the other night that brought his teammates off the bench.
That's right.
And was affirmation that he was back.
Mm-hmm. Well, I really think this is a great challenge for Duke and something that defending champions need as they make their run for a repeat championship. You think about what it takes to win back-to-back championships. You've got to stay healthy. You've got to stay focused. You need to play with great intensity. But every now and then, you need an extra challenge to give you that extra flow of adrenaline. And this young California team with Jason Kidd and Lamond Murray and Brian Hendrick, I think it's something that Duke very much looks forward to. It's a great challenge and a great opportunity to, again, make a statement about them being serious about making it a three-peat.
Saw the bench stand during the free throws. Now they're down. Here's the steal. Hurley for three. Hendrick with the rebound. Taken away by Thomas Hill. And Hendrick with the foul.
I talked about poise and attitude early for Cal. You can't discount handling Duke's pressure. And so far, a couple of quick turnovers by California.
Hurley will inbound 4-2 early on. We played less than a minute and a half. Derek E. Parks, Grant Hill, Antonio Lang, Hurley, and Thomas Hill.
Cal showing the zone.
Parks tied at four. At the other end, K.J. Roberts. No, too strong. Loose ball. Kidd has it. Antonio Lang for Duke. Grant Hill. He does play high.
And another turnover by California. They want to play at 78 RPMs. They need it fast, but they've got to handle the ball. Here you take a look at Bobby Hurley finding Grant Hill. He's back and well.
Grant Hill, who sat out six games with that injury, and a Duke team that lost its last two, the last in regular season to North Carolina and then to Georgia Tech, but they were awesome in winning 105-70 the other night. Here's a foul away from the ball.
I think it was Cherokee Parks with the swim stroke.
First team foul, or first foul on Parks, second team foul. Jason Kidd, number five, said he grew up admiring Magic Johnson. Hurley guarding Kidd. Hurley grew up admiring Larry Bird. Here's Roberts. Kidd for three. Got it.
Well, the butterflies have probably settled, and typically that'll happen once you work up that first lather.
7-6, California leads. 17-22 to go first half. Grant Hill. Perfect.
So smooth.
8-7, Duke. K.J. Roberts.
Now, this is a guy who started most of the games last year at point guard, so he has some experience and plenty of quickness. Hurley defending Kidd now.
Underneath the Kendrick. And he's fouled. He'll shoot free throws.
You know, you talk about California being a young team, but they feel like they match up very well with Duke. And I think one of the other elements that will be critical as you take a look at Todd Bozeman talking with Jason Kidd, one of the other key elements will be bench play today.
Mm-hmm.
Duke pretty much will play Chris Collins, Eric Meek, and Marty Clark, and maybe Kenny Blakeney a little bit. Cal plays typically 10 guys double-digit minutes, so bench play will be also a factor today.
Duke got 39 points off the bench the other night, led by Marty Clark and Chris Collins. Collins had 16 points. Hendrick gets the first of two. We are tied at eight. This, by the way, is not the first. Oh, Cherokee Parks. A little in your face. There's no, just a warning here, no foul call.
Right, and a good job. That's left side of the screen. Take a look at Parks and Grigsby. Let's see what happens here. There's a little elbow and then a little extracurricular. Good job by the official to step in and say, hey, fellas, let's park all of that.
9-8 California, 16:48 to go first half. This, by the way, the second meeting between these two schools. First occurred back in 1983, and Cal won that. A season opener at the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum. Cherokee Parks. Kidd tips it to Hendrick. And now Cal's on the run. Lamond Murray, guarded by Grant Hill.
That's another excellent matchup. We talked about that at the top. Parks and Hendrick is the third marquee matchup, I think. Parks playing extremely well of late.
Tip, too strong. Grant Hill rebound for the Dukes. 9-8 California. Thomas Hill, California with the ball. What a pass.
He's got great vision and, again, is stronger than most point guards he faces. Jason Kidd averages 5 rebounds a game from the point guard spot.
Cal with a 3-point edge. They jumped out to a 4-0 lead to open the ball game. Duke came storming back to reclaim the lead. Parks. Watch the pass by California.
Jason Kidd finding Alfred Grigsby inside. Count it.
Back at the Rosemont Horizon, where California has taken an early lead over Duke, 11-8. And here's Thomas Hill on the inbound play for Duke, stripped away by Jason Kidd. That is the fourth Duke turnover early in the game. The three-pointer by Murray, no. Grigsby over the back. Yes. Alfred Grigsby, the sophomore from Houston, guilty of the foul.
Not only does Kidd have quick hands, but they're really strong. When he gets his hands on the ball, typically he takes it away from whoever has it. And there you see him building on his Pac-10 season record in steals. He established that the other night, breaking Gary Payton's record, who played at Oregon State and is now with the Seattle Supersonics in the NBA.
Kidd gets the rebound.
Well, they really
Jones
want to push
it in. Achille Jones and Grant Hill knocked it out of bounds. They do, don't they?
They really want to step on the throttle and rebound and get out and run, and I think that's their best strategy, not allow Duke to get into the half-court pressure defense.
Stevie Johnson, number 22, a freshman from Baltimore, Maryland, comes in. He replaces Grigsby. And Achille Jones, we've mentioned, had come in the lineup wearing number 33. So it's Lamond Murray. Here's Hendrick looking underneath for Johnson. Murray and Kidd. Grant Hill doing the defensive work for Duke. Hendrick drops it down. The basket good.
Beautiful pass and catch. Hendrick and Murray hooking up for the Deuce.
Lead is 5 for California. Hurley is fouled in the act of shooting.
One way to be good D is put it on the floor and beat your man and force help. Hendrick does that. Grant has to help. And then Lamond Murray loose underneath. See, Grant Hill had to come help, and that left Murray loose underneath, and a nice find by Brian Hendrick.
Thomas Hill is going to get a rest, and Marty Clark comes in. And for California, Ryan Jamison, the sophomore 6'11 center, comes into the lineup. Bobby Hurley goes to the free throw line.
It looks like Todd Bozeman is going to play a number of different people on Bobby Hurley. Achille Jones and K.J. Roberts have the foot speed, as does Jason Kidd. And that's a good move. You don't want to get Jason Kidd to any unnecessary foul trouble. And you also have a chance to give Hurley different looks and maybe try to wear him down a bit.
Lead is 3 for California. They've got Kidd and Jamison, Johnson, Jones, and Murray on the floor now. Johnson tipped away by Marty Clark. Grant Hill has it. And here come the Blue Devils with a chance to tie or come within one. Antonio Lang goes right up over Murray. Too strong. Jason Kidd battles, and Duke has it.
Antonio Lang, really in my mind, a key player for Duke because he played so well while Grant Hill was out of the lineup, and since Grant has returned, he's kind of slid back into the shadows, and he needs to step up on the backboards and also in point production.
Antonio Lang found himself on the line, and that's five Duke turnovers in the early going.
Well, the question has been answered. We talked about Jason Kidd's nervousness, but this team seems to be very much relaxed right now.
Marty Clark knocks it away. Cowball. It's really an amazing story, this California Golden Bear team. Those of you who are not familiar with it, here come Eric Meek into the lineup and Chris Collins. Todd Bozeman took over as the interim coach on February 8th. Lou Campanelli was fired because of verbal abuse, among other things. At the age of 29, Bozeman took over a team that was 10-7 and in turmoil. They have gone 10-1 since then, including a thrilling win over LSU in the first round of the NCAA tournament here. Achille Jones. Meek quickly out to Collins, who had 16 points off the bench the other night. The freshman who is playing not far from where he grew up. Grant Hill. Meek. Foul.
Meek does a great job on the boards. In his last six games, he's gotten 30 rebounds, and that's in limited playing time. So he does a good job with his minutes in terms of eating glass.
Monty Buckley is going to enter the game now, number three for California. And Eric Meek, who is one of two Californians in the Duke roster. He and Cherokee Park, both in the Southern California area. Meek from Escondido, home of well-known golfers. Gary McCord, you owe me. 13-10. Lots of family ties, neighborhood ties, father and son stories in this game.
Well, we've got plenty of that, but we'll...
A lot of subplots.
Mm-hmm.
Eric Meek, it's 13-11, California.
See, I think Jason Kidd wants Jones to handle the ball. And he's going to try to post up one of the two Duke guards. Collins going to defend him now.
Now, there are a couple of kids who met each other at the McDonald's All-Star game last year.
And various summer camps as well.
Chris Collins and Jason Kidd. Zone defense for Duke. Kidd. Oh, boy! Oh! Ignore the fact the ball didn't go in. It was a terrific play.
Everything but the great look away against the zone when you make the diagonal pass. It's available. He's not even looking at Jamison. Gets it to him. He doesn't finish. But Murray right there in place for the second shot opportunity. And Cal will inbound on the baseline.
To Lamond Murray. Takes the jumper and hits it.
Murray, the cousin of Tracy Murray, now a member of the Portland Trail Blazers in the NBA, played his college ball at UCLA. And as they like to say in the neighborhood, Lamond Murray can go, period.
I'm going to learn a lot hanging with you. I just got that feeling.
So can he. Grant Hill.
Yes, he can go. Lamond Murray count the basket and let him shoot a free throw.
Here you take a look at Murray coming right at you. He's got the long arms, nice handle, the extension. Meek not quite there. Mark it up. Lamond has 23 points, 10 boards, a couple of assists, a couple of steals, a block shot or two on Thursday night, and that's why we call him a stat sheet stuffer supreme.
Misses the free throw. Here was Doug Collins reacting to that last play. Doug, of course, All-American, member of the Philadelphia 76ers, coach of the Bulls, and now a television analyst, flew in on the red eye Wednesday night to watch his son Chris play. And said one reason he doesn't want to get back into coaching right now is that he, as a father, wants to enjoy Chris's 4 years at Duke.
And there can't be anything more special than to sit here and watch your son play big-time ball. Bobby Hurley. Bobby Hurley and Achilles Jones, a little jaw-jacking.
17-16 California. Jason Kidd and Hurley.
I think he wants to take Bobby.
Well, Grant Hill took him. And here's Duke's chance for the lead. Hurley, nice assist. Basket, no. Clark has the ball. Loose ball. Duke ball. Time is called. 11:21 to go. First quarter, down by one. Signs abound here at the Rosemont Horizon, as you might expect, with a crowd of 17,000. California up 17-16. Marty Clark, Grant Hill, Eric Meek, Chris Collins, and Bobby Hurley on the floor for Duke.
Cal showing a 2-3 zone. They'll match up out of this. And with their quickness, they should be able to challenge all shots.
Here's Kidd on Hurley. Neither team shooting particularly well early in the game. And there's a quick hand of Monty Buckley. Achilles Jones takes it back outside. Jason Kidd with Marty Clark guarding him. Hello!
Boy, he has such great vision and really delights more in making passes than he does in scoring himself. You love his strength, his tenacity, but most of all, I guess you have to love his vision.
Dale Brown, the losing coach in the game the other night from LSU, said, well, the Cold War is over, but we could take Kidd and put him in Alaska and use him as radar.
Yeah, that's right. That's
an early warning system. Let's take a look at the lob. Kidd gets the foul.
And it helps to have a receiver that finishes like Lamond Murray does. No pressure on the ball, though. Beautifully executed, and Lamond Murray makes it all work. When you guard Jason Kidd, you have to get tremendous pressure on him, but he's so strong and quick that if you crowd him, he can get around you and get into the heart of your defense. So you can't take away everything that he does. If anything, you try to play him for the jump shot.
Grant Hill and Chris Collins will sit down. There is such a thing in sport as genetic advantage, and those two kids have it. Chris Collins' father, of course, Doug, you've seen him. Grant Hill's father, Calvin, is here. On the other side of the line, you've got Brian Hendrick, whose dad, George, was a great baseball player. New rule in NCAA athletics now because of the blood. Marty Clark will leave the game.
He'll leave and get properly attended to, and once the bleeding has been stopped or covered, he can return.
Meek misses. Here's Brian Hendrick. George. His father was his dad. I was an English major. That's a little.
Yeah, but you made the point. You just were a bit redundant there, but that's okay.
They're known for that. 19-17. California up by two, 10:05 to go first half. Kidd on Hurley. Antonio Lang guards Monty Buckley. Jared Hass is in the lineup now, too, number 12. Johnson, nope. Oh, my goodness. There is luck in this game.
Look what I found.
Fortunate bounce, or tip, as it were. 21-17, California.
Here's the matchup we talked about. We won't see this an awful lot, but right now, Kidd on Hurley. Both of these guys have excellent feet.
Parks Hill. Offensive foul.
Take a look. You'll see this one plain and clear. Thomas Hill trying to post pass and then watch the wing. See that? Actually, he extended that chicken wing. That was more like a stiff arm to get that advantage, and a good call there by Eric Harmon.
Grant Hill checks back into the lineup. Cherokee Parks, Lang, Hill, and Hurley.
Well, Duke really unable to get anything off their defense. They've made it a half-court game, which I thought would hurt Cal as Jason Kidd walks into the lane.
He's got to wait a few years before he can get away with that move.
Or he's got to get better in disguising it, one or the other.
9:14 to go first half. 21-17, Cal has led through much of the first half. They jumped out to a 4-0 lead. Duke came back to take an advantage, but Cal grabbed it back, and they've kept it. Buckley tries to save it, but he's across the line. It'll be Duke's to throw in. This is not the same Duke outfit we saw Thursday night.
I was just thinking the exact same thing. The tenacity, the intensity, the aggressive posture that they showed. Well,
just
that part is back.
Yeah, that's for two. And it's 21-19. They won by 35 points the other night, 105-70 over Southern Illinois University, in the process setting a record for number of points they scored in a tournament game.
And they shot 63% from the floor.
No 5-second call. Back it goes to Hendrick. Jump hook, no. Grant Hill with a rebound. And a chance for Duke to tie, but they will not.
Credit that turnover to Jason Kidd. He got a piece of it, then it last touched Hurley. Again, just filtering back into the passing lane. Excellent anticipation.
Lamond Murray comes back in the lineup. Monty Buckley goes out. And Alfred Grigsby comes in, leaving Stevie Johnson to go to the bench. Duke with 8 turnovers thus far. California has scored 9 points off those turnovers. This is Jared Haas, number 12. And Grant Hill almost took it away. Jason Kidd will throw it in. Entry pass. Grigsby back to Kidd.
Grigsby really working hard to get post position on Parks inside. Oh, nice job by Hurley.
Not shy about putting it up. And Grigsby with a strong rebounding effort. And that'll be a two-shot foul.
This game hasn't established much flow.
No, it has been kind of herky-jerky in the last 10 minutes.
Stop and start. And nothing easy. Both of these teams playing really pretty good at the half court in their half court defense.
Alfred Grigsby gets the free throw. He's a 65% shooter for the course of the season. Jason Kidd's going to get a breather. And K.J. Roberts comes in replacing Jason Kidd.
Well, Todd Bozeman doing a nice job of getting people in and out, keeping his players fresh. Making good use of his bench.
Grigsby gets them both. Jason Kidd gets a rest. Time has been called, and Cal leads by 4. Fans are here. Cheerleaders are here. 17,000 fans are here. And they've seen California post a 4-point edge over the Duke Blue Devils with 7:50 remaining in the first half. Neither team continues to shoot well.
Both teams playing pretty good defense, though. I think you have to give both teams credit for what they've done defensively. They've mixed it up man-to-man and zone. And there haven't been many second shots either way.
Here's Hendrick. Back it goes to K.J. Roberts. Jared Haas, number 12. Grigsby. and Lamond Murray. No call. Pass. 2 points just inside the line.
Well, he too started most of this season and just recently was taken out of the starting lineup in favor of K.J. Roberts, so they bring the starting guard off the bench.
Cherokee Parks has to battle for that, and Grigsby saves it. Here's Roberts.
Well, Duke does such a nice job getting back on defense. That's another reason that there haven't been many easy shots. Both teams transitioning well defensively.
Antonio Lang guards Lamond Murray now. Here's a takeaway by Hurley. Finds Thomas Hill, but K.J. Roberts gets there first. 9 Duke turnovers. Basket too strong.
Oh, a big board by Grant Hill.
Hurley. Hill. 25-21. 6:20 to go, first half.
Boy, nice switch by Antonio Lang.
Alfred Grigsby scores from in close to reestablish a California lead of 6. California playing in blue, Duke in white. Cal jumped off to a 4-0 edge. Duke came back to reclaim the lead. But for most of the first half, the Golden Bears have been on top. Grant Hill misses for Duke. And it's another rebound for Brian Hendricks.
Well, they've got numbers if they push.
Jason Kidd waiting to get back in the game. Grigsby! Oh, boy, the lead is 8.
What a catch and finish. But they had numbers. Both Hills were back. And once Brian Hendricks was able to get it up ahead, they were able to get numbers.
Hurley.
How many times have you seen that, Burn? When they need a big basket, he shoots one of those rally-wrecking threes.
In the heart. 5-12 remaining first half.
Huge hoop by Hurley. Good ball pressure here.
5-second count.
And he begged for that one. He lobbied for that one and got it.
Jason Kidd comes back in for California. Marty Clark checks in for the Duke Blue Devils. Let's check the lineup now. Clark, Hurley, Thomas Hill, Eric Meek, and Antonio Lang for Duke. And for California, it's Hass and Kidd at the guards. Lamond Murray, Hendrick, and Ryan Jameson. Foul is on Jason Kidd, his second. That is the team 8.
California personal number 5, Jason Kidd, his second.
Jason Kidd, who grew up in the Oakland area, not far from the Cal campus in Berkeley, but almost went to Kansas.
Right.
It came down to a decision to stay close to home.
Proximity to home often is a big factor with any high school recruit.
Well, if California can win this game, and they lead right now with a long way to go, they would take on Kansas next week in St. Louis in the round of 16. This is the final game in this area of the Midwest region, but more action coming up tomorrow from Indianapolis, where Indiana, the top seed, takes on Xavier, and Louisville takes on Oklahoma State. Those games tomorrow.
Well, I think they get Lamond Murray on the push-off as we look at what's going on tomorrow. Xavier and Indiana, Wake Forest and Iowa, UCLA and Michigan. So
those are the key games to be televised tomorrow. There is other action as well, of course, as we try and give you at least a taste of everything that's going on around the country in the NCAA championship. 29-26, and Clark goes to the free throw line. Last foul was on Lamond Murray.
Yeah, you just saw the advantage Duke has had at the free throw line. +4 and make, +5 in attempt.
Marty Clark, another from Chicago area. The Duke bench, Cherokee Parks, Grant Hill.
Well, Clark had a big game the other night. Off the bench, knocked in 13 points on 3 of 4 3-point field goals.
That's 7 points in a row for the Blue Devils. They're back to within one.
Clark and Lamond Murray working hard inside.
Garrett has for three. Hurley gets the screen. Antonio Lang provides it.
He's ready. He's going to try to carry the Blue Devils himself this half. It's plainly obvious for the last two possessions he's looking for his shot.
Lamond Murray.
Strap him up, folks.
35-31. 3:53 to go first half. Marty Clark.
They've been running a little brush screen for Hurley. Nobody up top now, but kid needs some help with communication from a teammate when they look the screen in.
Clark way out of position. And Jason Kidd's quick hands save the ball. Here's Kidd.
Oh!
Tips it and puts it in all the way. Lamond Murray hurt at the other end of the court.
But
37-31, time has been called.
Here you take a look at Marty Clark. Now right in here you're going to see Lamond Murray try to challenge the shot, and he's going to come down on Marty Clark's foot. There you saw his left ankle. And how severe the sprain is, we don't know. There he is during the timeout, actually taking a look, and he's out of the game now, but you hope he'll be able to return.
On the floor right now for Duke, Grant Hill, Bobby Hurley. Here's Thomas Hill, Cherokee Parks, and Marty Clark. Taken away, tip. Here's Jared Hass. He's got Monty Buckley, but he takes it all the way.
How big has he been this half?
Wow.
Tremendous move in transition, but the quick hands.
Here's Hurley. No. Saved by Kidd, and he went flying two rows back. Traveling cowball.
Speed, hustle, determination, tenacity. Look at this. Come fly with me. Jason Kidd. And then how he got through there without much contact. Here we go again. Long jump, save it. Bounce, plant, break your fall, and then come back and take it out of bounds for your team. That's on the scale of 1 to 10. That's probably a 9-7.
That's a new meaning of trust. 39-31, 2.5 to go. Hurley. Grant Hill, who hit a three-pointer the other day, he's got only three in his career. Tried that one and missed. Jason Kidd. Monty Buckley for three. It's 42-31. Krzyzewski's team down by 11. Chris Collins with the dish. Jason Kidd's quick hands get it back. For three. Buckley, who averages 4.1 points per game, has hit back-to-back three-pointers. California is on a 13-0 run. Jason Kidd has found a number he likes.
5 points. Wild.
Bobby Hurley trying to keep Duke in it. And if anybody can, he's the man.
He certainly is. This will be three free throws for Hurley as that foul was committed behind the arc. And that's the one way you really don't want to stop your run. You want to force the team to score in a hard-earned fashion. And instead, Hurley has a chance to pare the lead by three.
Of all the unexpected big men in this game, Monty Buckley in 28 previous games had hit 9 baskets from three-point range.
How about Gerard Hash?
Yes.
He's been huge, too. I think he's got 7 points. So that's 13 from guys you're not looking for big numbers from.
Here's Buckley to Hash, and Chris Collins guards him. The lead is 11. Now it's back to 13.
Look at the body language. Look at the heads up, the chest heaving. This team feels like they've got Duke reeling and trying to really put the clamp down now.
Hurley gets the pick. Hass is guarding Hurley now. On the line. It'll be Duke ball. Jason Kidd couldn't quite save it. Coming up at halftime, we'll check in on the Santa Clara game. Santa Clara with the big win over Arizona the other night. Jim Nance, Bill Raftery, and Mike Francesa along. And Santa Clara holding tough in its game against Temple. Bobby Hurley will inbound. A 13-0 Cal run. Marty Clark. Good position for Jamison. And Cherokee Parks is guilty of the foul, and he is down. Left ankle, I think.
Here you take a look. The shot by Clark. Look in the middle of your screen. There's the block out by Jamison, and then Parks steps on Jamison's foot. It was two left feet that collided, and Parks got the brunt of the damage. And Bobby Hurley, too, is down at the other end now, shedding some tape that I think was on his heel, and I can't imagine him out there without socks.
They're going to take Cherokee Parks right into the locker room.
Here it is again. Clark from up top, right in the middle of your screen. There's the over the back, and then Cherokee Parks comes down hard on Ryan Jamison's foot.
Left ankle.
The officials wanted to see that again and determine who should be shooting the free throw, and they got it right as Jamison clearly was inside, and he'll go to the line.
Look at the edge Duke has had at the free throw line, but despite that advantage, they trail by 13.
The three-point shots.
Right. Hass and Buckley particularly.
Mm-hmm.
Lamond Murray went down with an ankle injury, very similar to that which happened at Cherokee Parks. And we get word from Leslie Visser that Lamond Murray will not play the, well, we've only got 25 seconds left in the half, but they will try and get him back for the second half of the ball game. 47-34, a 13-0 run sparked by Jared Hass and Monty Buckley.
And during that run, Duke was primarily a perimeter team, nothing inside.
Chris Collins. That will help the Duke cause. But despite the three-pointer from the freshman from nearby Glenbrook, Illinois, Duke trails by 10. Jim Nance and Bill Raftery, along with Mike Francesa, along with At the Half, after this word and a message from your local stations. Cal up by 10. Let's get an injury update right now from Leslie Visser.
Vern, a stunned Duke team took the floor after the half. Assistant coach Peacock guessed that we're not sustaining our effort on defense. We're not finishing the plays on offense. As for the injury, Cal's Lamond Murray will start. He's back out here. But Cherokee Parks, who rolled over on his left ankle, did not come out of the locker room. He will not play in the second half. Keep in mind, Vern, that 6 of 7 of Duke's losses this year came when they trailed at the half. Vern? Warren.
All right, Leslie, in the action, the obvious question, Clark Kellogg, is what does the loss of Cherokee Parks mean to
you? Well, obviously you missed a low post score. Parks only had 2 points and one rebound, but he had been playing so well lately. Now that means Thomas Hill, Grant Hill, and also Bobby Hurley have to really step up now and be aggressive and assertive offensively, and it might make Duke become more of a perimeter-oriented team.
How difficult to overcome this 10-point deficit?
Well, I think part of what Cal wants to do is keep Duke off the foul line. Had they kept Duke off the foul line, they would be up by far more than the 10 they're up. Duke made 13 or 15 free throws to stay within 10 points. Duke, on the other hand, is going to have to be aggressive. They've got to get themselves to the basket and try to draw fouls.
Lamond Murray is back.
Boy, you take a look at what Cal did in the last 7-15. 10 of 12, including a few three-point shots. And Duke, on the other hand, 6 of 21 if you take away what Hurley did. And he made 4 of 6, including 3 of 5 from behind the arc.
Hurley opens up on Jason Kidd. Lamond Murray playing with the injured ankle. And there's another fortuitous bounce right into the arms of Grigsby. Roberts back to Kidd. Roberts for 3. Whoa! Deadly.
You don't draw it up like that when you X and O it, but you'll take the result, and just what Cal needed to maintain their confidence and their run.
Stolen by Kidd. And it's going to be a foul called on Grigsby, his third.
Well, again, I really think the only way Duke really gets back into this is through coming up with points off their defense, knocking down some threes, and trying to get Cal into some foul trouble so they can make a run with getting free throws.
Chris Collins opens the second half on the floor, the freshman off guard. Now he's got the ball. He's being guarded by Jason Kidd. It's K.J. Roberts on Hurley and Lamond Murray on Thomas Hill.
Interesting to watch Lamond Murray, how he moves on that left ankle. A right-handed player, that's usually his launch pad foot, the left one.
14 on the shot clock. There's the pick from Grant Hill. Collins all the way. Basket interference. No basket.
But that's the kind of effort they need, Vern. They need penetration into the lane and aggressiveness on the glass. This shot almost goes for Collins. And Antonio Lang, so you look at the basketball. Where's the orange? Still on the rack. Good call.
Earlier today, North Carolina made it into the round of 16 for the 13th consecutive year. Duke has the second longest string. They have been in for 7 straight years. They're in danger of not making it back right now. Johnson. Especially when the ball falls like that.
Well, that's what happens when you get it going your way. You start getting the break because you've made some earlier.
Thomas Hill. Murray. K.J. Roberts. Basket.
K.J. Roberts knows Lamond Murray is coming. Room service. Collins in no position to stop the goal. Mark it up. And there can't be much wrong with that ankle. I mean, he stepped it up a notch when he saw a basket at the other end.
You gave me some neighborhood lingo in the first half. Here's some middle-aged Scandinavian jive. Usta.
Now break that down for me and our audience.
That's a Scandinavian way of saying wow.
Oh, okay.
As in Uksa.
Okay.
Bobby Hurley.
Bobby Hurley, strong to the goal here. Just gets between Johnson and K.J. Roberts. Great body control. And Duke needs more of that. They need aggressive plays in the paint area, and obviously with Parks out of the lineup, you can't do it by throwing it inside to somebody. So Grant Hill, who can take you off the dribble, Bobby Hurley, who can do it, those two guys really have to step up and try to get themselves to the basket.
Lead is 15 at 55-40. Here's Murray, back to Kidd.
And if you're Cal, you become selective, not tentative, but you make sure you get the shot you want, not the shot that first presents itself.
And the bounce goes right back Cal's way again. Murray, Hendrick. No, but the rebound to Thomas Hill. 55-40, Bobby Hurley. Antonio Lang. Walsh.
I think Hill a little undecided as to what he wanted to do on that move. And there you see Cal minus five in the turnover area.
Murray gets the rebound of K.J. Roberts' shot. And you know, now they'll reset.
Lamond Murray has big-time hops. He can really get off the floor, but he has tremendously long arms, too. His extra shirt length certainly helps him when he gets into the paint.
Hendrick backs in. And the tip goes.
Went and got it. I've always said that when you shoot a shot inside of 8 feet, you should be the first guy to get to the offensive rebound because you know how it came off your hand and you have an idea of where it may end up.
Hurley for three. Bobby Hurley in his career at Duke is 18-1 in NCAA tournament games. The only time he and Thomas Hill have lost came in the 1990 championship game to UNLV. They will not quit.
No, they certainly won't, and Hurley doing all that he can. He needs a teammate to step up and join him in the point parade. Nobody else really giving Duke any numbers, and Hurley pretty much their sole offensive weapon now.
Last foul was on Thomas Hill, and he'll sit along with Collins and Antonio Lang. That's the second foul for Thomas Hill. And Stevie Johnson goes to the line. Johnson, a freshman from Baltimore at 6'9", 210. And he shoots a couple.
And you know, thinking about what Hurley did in the first half and what he's done here in the first three-plus minutes, it's almost impossible for any team to win when their point guard has to become their primary scorer. Your point guard is a guy that needs to distribute and set up other people and score only to keep the defense honest. So if Hurley has to become the go-to guy and the primary scorer, I think it's going to wear him out and Duke won't have a chance to get back. Somebody else has to join it.
Somewhere today I read something about winning in the NCAA is 45% talent, 45% coaching, 10% luck. And thus far, there's been a lot of luck. But Todd Bozeman, can you imagine in 1986 when he was a senior at Rhode Island, in his career plan, he said, well, let's see, 1993, head coach in Cal, beating Duke by 15 in the second round of the NCAAs in Chicago.
No, I don't think any crystal ball he could have rubbed would have come up with that.
Grant Hill, 58-46. They need to concentrate now on just getting it. Well, forget what I was about to say.
They're in a groove. They're in a groove in a zone. We saw it at the end of the first half.
Murray has 19. Grant Hill, no. Rebound, Lamond Murray. The lead is back to 15, and 15-35 remains in the game. Kidd. Taken away by Kenny Blakeney. Almost traveled. Hurley for three. Yes! He's got 27 points, a career high.
And he won't stop now. That's one of the best times to stroke the three in transition. Defenders go to the paint. They leave you open behind the line.
Pass off Hurley. Dives. Duke ball.
Cal getting a little impatient here. Plenty of time on the clock. Take a look at Bobby Hurley. He's maxing it out.
Time has been called. It's a young California team, seven sophomores and four freshmen, most of them recruited, all of them, as a matter of fact, by Todd Bozeman.
And he seems to be pretty much relaxed and composed, but the key for him is to continue to impress upon his team how well they've played, and yet this is not near over.
Johnson off Grant Hill.
Yeah, they've got to continue to be aggressive. Far too much time on the clock, and we know Duke in last year's game against Indiana was down 12 and came back in the tournament. So Cal must continue to play the game they've played throughout.
Pass. That's a pretty good way to do it.
Yeah, he's been huge. He and Buckley really were the catalyst in that run that gave him the double-digit lead at the half.
3-point field goals, 8 of 13 for California. Johnson, Kidd, it's 3-on-2. Johnson loses it, and Grant Hill gets it to Bobby Hurley. Now 3-on-2 the other way. Oh, that's gorgeous.
He is having some kind of game.
29 points for Bobby Hurley.
You just wonder, though, about the fuel tank. Can he maintain the level that he's played at throughout, having to be the guy carrying most of the offensive load for Duke?
Kenny Blakeney is going to get called on the foul of Jared Hass.
One-on-one. Little shake. He has the defender backpedaling, leans in off balance, a gentle kiss, and you can't do it much better than that in transition.
Last foul was on Kenny Blakeney. That's only the fourth team foul.
Hurley with 29 and 5 assists, and Lamond Murray showing you why I called him a special player.
That's unconscious. Change my Scandinavian lingo. I'm on your side. The man can go. Blakeney answers with 2. 67-53. Pass. Oh, boy! Wow!
Oh, my. This is similar to what Duke showed us Thursday night.
Eric Meek taken away by Hess. On the line, Duke ball.
Todd Bozeman saying, come on, gang. We had a break going the other way. How impressive is this? I mean, there's plenty of time, but you just see the Cal club oozing with confidence. I mean, Hass is just pulling up for 3, so is Lamond Murray. But the only danger with that now is that if you get cold, you've gotten so comfortable pulling up after 1 and 2 passes, shooting the 3. If you hit a dry spell, you give the opposition, Duke in this case, an opportunity to get back into it. Boy, is that Cherokee Parks being strapped up?
They're working on his left ankle, Grant Hill. Under 13 minutes to go, the lead is 15, 70-55. Got a little cute.
Yeah, I don't think.
Oh, goodness. Grigsby.
Hurley trying to go upstairs against Alfred Grigsby. It won't work. Great timing. He never allowed Hurley to get his body on him. See, he broke contact and kept the space, but they did get chest to chest after the denial.
Hendrick works on Antonio Lang. That shot for 3. Grant Hill, that's only the 3rd three-pointer of his career.
And he's had, 2 of them in the last couple of games.
As a matter of fact, it's the 4th, and it's the 3rd in the last 3 games.
You wonder about the youth of Cal maybe relaxing a little too soon. You know Duke, with a champion's heart, won't quit.
Not with plays like that. They can get it to 10 or 9. Oh, One pass into the hands of Grant Hill. Pass is back. Thomas Hill.
Well, the TV timeout is right on the horizon. Cal needs a good possession right here.
Mike Krzyzewski is down on the floor, pounding it.
I think you need to look for something in the paint.
Rebound, Duke. Foul on Grigsby. Calvin Hill on the right in the blue vest. Doug Collins on the left. Both sons, integral parts of this Duke effort. Sellout crowd at the Rosemont Horizon, second round game in the Midwest region. It has been a dandy. Cal seeded sixth, led by as many as 17. They're up by 10 right now, 70-60. Here comes Grant Hill. Goes by Murray. Thomas Hill takes it in, and it is into single digits for the first time since late in the first half.
Aggressive move to the basket, and that made possible because of the excellent shooting Duke has displayed here in the second half.
Put back is in. Murray has 24 points. And there are 10 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the ballgame.
Good move here to let Grant Hill create, because he can do that. See, he can pull up and shoot that mid-range J, and Murray can't do anything about it. Or he draws defenders and dishes to the cutting heel or the wide-open Bobby Hurley.
72-64, 10-20 on the clock. Akili Jones, number 33. Johnson looks inside. That's knocked away. Grant Hill defending, and it'll be Duke ball. Antonio Lang will throw it in. A 13-0 run in the first half propelled Cal to a 10-point halftime edge. They led by as many as 17 within the last 3 minutes. But behind Bobby Hurley and Grant Hill, Duke has come back. They trail by 8 with 9:53 to go.
Cal now settling into a zone. They got burned the last few times in their man-to-man set.
Hurley for 3. Kidd. And the foul is going to be called on Thomas Hill. That's his 3rd and the 5th team foul.
That's one of the things Jason gives you from the guard spot that you typically don't get from your point guard, and that's rebounding. He averages 5 a game. He's got 9 in addition to 4 steals, 13 assists, and 5 points. So he's in TD territory,
which
triple-double, triple-double territory. I know Al McGuire likes to call 3-point shots touchdowns, but Jason Kidd definitely a stat sheet stuffer supreme.
You say that so quickly and with such authority. Here's Duke. 72-64. Bobby Hurley. Grant Hill.
You just wonder about the experience taking over here for Duke and Cal, getting a little complacent, a little tentative. But you know a championship team will make a run at you.
Thomas Hill. Doug Collins is among those on their feet. The lead is 5. Buckley. 3-on-1. .28 remaining in the game. Duke has saved the lead to 3. They've outscored Cal 16-2 in the last 4 minutes and 45 seconds. Grant Hill and Thomas Hill, 16 points, Cal 2.
And we said that somebody had to join Hurley, and both heels have stepped up to do just that.
Antonio Lang with the block. Hurley to Grant Hill. No basket. Foul before the shot. Lamond Murray with a foul, his third. 15 foul.
Here you take a look at Grisby trying to get inside. Beats Meek, but great help by Antonio Lang for the denial.
Lang with the rebound. Meek with the putback. Eric Meek will shoot two. And for the first time tonight, you see looks of valid concern in California kids' faces.
That's right, and that's part of their youth. They've never been in this situation in a game of this magnitude. They've come from behind and had leads and let them get away in some regular season games, but with everything on the line here, as you look at the free throw numbers, this is a different kind of test for this Cal team.
Meek cuts it to a two-point edge. Temple beats Santa Clara. And they go to the round of 16. This could cut it to one. The last lead for Duke came with 17 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the first half. The score then was 8-7. They now trail by one.
Get tentative here if you're Cal. You got to get a good look. Murray and Kidd are your go-to guys.
Seven turnovers for Cal during this run. Hell ball, possession arrow, Duke.
Boy, the Blue Devils have really stepped it up defensively and now have a chance to grab their first lead in a while. Here's a guy that is the point guard, the quarterback, the Velcro. He's the one that has to make sure the ball gets to the right place at the right time. And that time forced one inside, but an awful lot of responsibility for the young freshman.
That's eight turnovers for Cal in this half. They've led to 15 Duke points.
That's a pretty good conversion rate.
And the Blue Devils can take the lead for the first time since early in the ball game. But not this trip down. Kidd by Hurley. Left hand. Dandy.
How about the crossover dribble to get to the cup?
Foul by three.
Boy, what a huge basket that was, because it put Duke in a position to not be able to get the lead on this possession, barring a disastrous four-point play.
Thomas Hill. Watch Jason Kidd.
Watch him get busy here. Watch this crossover. Bang! And he's by Hurley. And then the improvisation and the use of the body in the left hand. Oh, five-star all the way.
Let the congregation stand.
Hey, this is too much fun. Look at him stuffing the stat sheet as you saw those numbers just momentarily. But
third foul on Kidd. Thomas Hill at the line. Four 73. 6:40 to go. Winner goes to St. Louis to take on Kansas.
And look at this. This is a little of Duke's medicine. They were trying to post up Jason Kidd, allowing Lamond Murray to handle it, much like Grant Hill will handle it at the point for Duke on occasion.
Blue Devils with a chance to reclaim the lead.
Clear out. little pick and roll, Hurley and Grant Hill. Good job by Hass to get over the top.
Good job by Hass to stay with him. Meade, no. Second time down, the Duke had a chance to take the lead and can't.
Those are very important possessions to note.
5:45 remaining. See what they do with Jason Kidd this time. He'll stay. No. Lamond Murray.
I think Meek in his effort to get to it was out of bounds. Boy, Grant Hill did a nice job of flying at the shooter. Take a look. See, he flies at Murray and forces him to double clutch a long-range jump shot.
Hendrick. Loose ball. Kidd.
Jason Kidd called the timeout because he didn't have anything to do with the orange.
Cal has one timeout left. Following our coverage of the NCAA tournament, it's Dr. Quinn, Medicine Woman, followed by Raven. That's tonight on CBS, except on the West Coast, where it will be seen in its regularly scheduled time. 74-73, Kidd, Hendrick, Grigsby, Hass, Lamond Murray on the court for Cal. That was almost another turnover. Instead, we get the foul called on Duke. Bring you up to date. In this half, Cal has turned it over 9 times, leading to 15 Duke points. They've outscored Duke 24-7 since falling behind by 18. Bobby Hurley with a career night, 29 points thus far in the ballgame. Jason Kidd has 13 assists, and he will inbound the ball here. Hendrick. 10 turnovers. And for the third time, Duke will come down with a chance to take the lead.
You can't give a team of this caliber that many opportunities to take the lead back. It's one thing to get a shot and then have it rebounded, but it's another thing not to even get a look at the basket, and Cal has done that on a number of trips here in the second half, and again, you point to their youth and inexperience.
Jason Kidd, quick hand, just about got it back.
Yeah, you can't be lazy with any passes around him. You got to make two-handed passes.
Thomas Hill. Nope. Grigsby rebound. That's 3 times now that Duke has come down with a chance to take the lead and hasn't done it.
Well, just as important as that is the fact that Cal has not gotten a shot the last few possessions they've had the ball down the court. I think you've got to find Murray or Kidd. They're trying to post Kidd on Hurley.
Grigsby. Now Kidd's got it. And Hurley's got him. 15 on the shot clock. Murray from the corner. 4-2. He's on the line.
What a sweet stroke he has. He got loose on the baseline and had just enough daylight to stroke it.
The lead is 3, the time 4 minutes. The 2-time national champion, Bobby Hurley, we are tied. The switch, Lang on Kidd. Too much. Taken away by Kidd.
So quick and so strong.
Grant Hill never saw him coming. Working on Bobby Hurley. Hendrick with a rebound. Back to Kidd, a fresh 45. Murray with the follow. Still won't go. Duke ball. California.
We are at 76 squared. This is the culmination of 6 shots by Cal. We're going to see 4. That's 2, 3. Grigsby now 4. Nothing goes down for the Bears, and Hill comes up with the board.
And meanwhile, in the stands, while the team huddles, Doug Collins and Calvin Hill got their heads together. That last timeout, by the way, was taken by Duke. The officials indicated that it was Cal's time. It was not. Hurley chases it down. 2:44 remaining.
Grant Hill trying to penetrate against the zone just enough to force him to leave Hurley by himself at the three-point line. He wants to knock down one of these back-breaking threes. That's what Hurley would love to do right now. He'd love to be able to pull up for a three.
Five on the shot clock. No. Rebound. Thomas Hill. Foul.
Well, that was excellent defense by California. A couple of deflections. Just didn't come up with the missed shot. But they forced Duke to fight the shot clock there.
With the score 8-7, Duke had its last lead. That was with 17 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the first half. If Thomas Hill can sink this, they reclaim the advantage.
Boy, how much has he stepped up here lately? Him and Grant Hill, they watched Hurley do most of the work until the last 7 minutes or so. They say every now and then they have to remind Thomas Hill to relax and idle down.
One of two as a team. Duke is 19 of 22 from the line. And they lead by one.
Murray picked up his fourth foul on that particular rebound sequence.
Pass.
Boy, kid on Hurley inside.
Grant Hill.
Ill-advised look. Not in rhythm. Not in the flow.
The Blue Devils have won the last two national titles. They trailed by 18 in this half at 67-49. They now lead by one. Hurley. Kidd. Two on two. No call. Grant Hill with the defense.
Here you take a look at Kidd. He wants to do it himself. Crossover dribble. Kept it in the same hand. Challenge. Boy, I tell you what, no whistle. And Kidd actually pushed that basketball out of bounds, it looked like. But heck, in that situation, with contact like that, probably a pretty good call to not whistle anything and let Cal retain possession.
Thomas Hill guarding Jason Kidd now. That kick loose. Blown out. Oh, my! Oh, goodness!
I've talked about how strong his hands are. Look at him get this thing out amongst traffic and then find the window. That peripheral vision, that strength, that's what we call being a player. Just find a way to make it happen.
Jason Kidd for his first free throw tonight. California leads by two. Duke calls timeout. Both Cal and Duke have one timeout left. Team fouls 8-7. The possession arrow favors California. Duke will inbound with 1:08 remaining. And the Blue Devils trailing California by two. It's Grant Hill, Bobby Hurley, Antonio Lang, Thomas Hill, and Chris Collins on the floor for Duke.
Cal in the zone. You've got to be careful of Hill. Thomas Hill and Bobby Hurley looking to pull up for the three. If they don't shoot the three, they'll penetrate and try to create off the dribble.
Traveling.
Mike Krzyzewski said he was pushed. There's Hash. Boy, he certainly got tripped, but that's incidental contact. But I think he took a good enough bounce there. Tough call.
Duke will press on the inbound.
They don't need to foul right away.
Brigsby gets it in the hands of Haas. Gotta watch out for Hurley. 40 seconds remaining.
Now they're gonna have to, yeah. There's only a 4 second differential between the game and shot clock.
How cool is Jason Kidd? California won the NCAA title in 1959. The last time they were in the Sweet 16, they defeated Santa Clara and lost in the national title.
You remember who beat them? The Ohio State Buckeyes.
With Lucas.
That's right.
And Knight.
Knight,
Havlicek.
Siegfried, no.
Jason Kidd.
FYI for our viewers, as he looked towards us after he was fouled, he told us he was making them both. Let's see.
That's what I was referring to when I said, how cool is he?
Too hard there.
One of two. Duke ball.
Oh, I think it went off Chris Collins.
Cal ball.
Well, obviously, if you're Duke, you've got to try to come up with a steal. If not, immediate foul.
Jason Kidd will inbound. Collins knocks it out of bounds. 35.1 seconds.
Well, you need to send somebody to the basket. You don't want to trap yourself at the half-court line and give Duke a chance to...
There's Grigsby. Collins fouls Haas. This will be the first time in 8 games that Jared Haas has been to the free throw line. He's an 80% free throw shooter, but has not been at the charity stripe for 8 games.
80% during the regular season is one thing. Knocking him down late in the tournament game is absolutely enough.
A chance to tie with a three-pointer. Hurley. Rebound Murray.
Big ball, Duke. He wrestles that thing out amongst two Blue Devils. Huge board, but more importantly, free throws have to be made. Gets a good look. It's right on line, just a little strong. Long board to the left. And look at Murray in traffic, using that extra shirt length to reel it in.
He's a 65% free throw shooter. He's one of two tonight. And he is shooting twice. Doug Collins.
I tell you what, it's much easier to be out there playing in this situation than to be watching as a parent. Or as a fan, or even as a broadcaster, heck, I've got butterflies, and I'm not there for anybody. What a great game this has been.
Hurley from the corner, no. The three-peat is about over. Hurley, no. 5.6 seconds left. Murray tracked it down. Foul by Thomas Hill. Seven sophomores and four freshmen, the most important of whom was that man, Bobby Hurley, All-American. His brother at Seton Hall also lost today. Lamond Murray at the line.
Well, it's ironic that Bobby and Danny Hurley talked about hooking up in New Orleans. That was their pre-tournament pack, and unfortunately today, both Seton Hall and Duke out of the tournament.
Hale wins it. wonderful shot of Mike Krzyzewski congratulating the heir apparent to Bobby Hurley, Jason Kidd. And it was Jason Kidd's brilliant three-point play, the rebound and the follow shot and the free throw that gave Cal a lead it never lost again. California, as the sixth seed, will take on Kansas. Our Chevrolet most valuable players, Jason Kidd, the freshman from California, Bobby Hurley with a career-high 32 points for Duke. This is a very young Cal team. They're in the Sweet 16, but with that man, it won't be the last time. Good night from Chicago.